Pinoy Panawagan is brought to you by Tancinco Law Offices.
And to dig deeper into this immigration development is Pinoy Panawagan Counsel Attorney Lou Tancinco, who now joins us here in the studio. Thank you for joining us on BA, Attorney Lou.
My pleasure to be here, Jeff.
We watched the package, news package of Don Tagala earlier, and they mentioned about some of the occupations that are really affected in this new ruling. Now, could you please explain to us any other occupations that would be affected by this?
Yes, as explained before, these are the H-2A, the agricultural workers. So we're referring to the farm, the laborers, and any kind of work related to the farm or even livestock. And then the second one is the H-2B, the temporary and seasonal. And we have already known the fact that there are a lot of Filipinos working temporarily in hotels, either at the front desk or whether they're cleaning, they're tending to the landscape or whatever. And then we also have, most importantly, some construction workers that are temporary in nature, most of them also in Guam or the CNMI. Other H-2B visa workers also could refer to maids or the cleaners. So these are the kind of workers that may be affected.
And many of our kababayans will be very much affected by this ruling.
Yes, also, Joe, I just want to emphasize, because there's a lot of news going on, they're just saying working visas. The working visa not affected are the H-1Bs, the O-1s, the J-1s. The Filipinos can still avail of those type of visas.
All right. Now, what happens now to Filipino workers whose H-2A or H-2B visa was just recently approved? Now, will he or she be able to still come to the United States and start working?
Well, generally, the ban is effective like for this year. So even if you have an approved visa petition, most likely the Department of State or the U.S. Embassy will not issue the visa unless you ask for the exception, which was also mentioned in the report. You have to show that there is a U.S. interest and that prior to that, you were already on an H-2B and you did not violate or overstay your visa.
Oh, so you can still appeal it?
Yes,
you can still make it happen.
It's not an absolute ban, yeah.
Now, of course, the Department of Homeland Security had cited human trafficking, overstaying, cases involving H-2A and H-2B visa holder. Now, will this one-year ban, which is until 2020, really still cover those victims of human trafficking who have received the T visa?
Well, it will not affect the T visa of those who are victims of human trafficking. The main reason that this ban was released is to protect victims of human trafficking. So they will still continue to have their T visas, or for those who are who they feel are victims of human trafficking, they can still apply for this type of visa.
All right. Thank you very much for clarifying this immigration policies that we have to deal with until 2020. Thank you, Attorney Lou Tancinco.
My pleasure.
And if you need advice for any legal problem, send your questions to pinoypanawagan at tancinco.com or call the hotline 1-800-999-9096.